Welcome to Designing with Hall Effect Sensors. In this video, you'll learn about how flow metering designs benefit from Hall Effect Sensors. In flow metering systems, it is important to be able to accurately determine the flow of a liquid. As the liquid flows through the flow meter, it rotates a mechanical assembly known as the impeller. The impeller is fixed with magnets such that a Hall sensor can detect the change in the magnetic field as the impeller rotates. The Hall Effect Sensor outputs a frequency which is proportional to the flow rate of a liquid. It is important to consider mechanical design elements when creating a flow meter, as these characteristics can translate to mechanical errors that dictate the performance and accuracy of the meter. One of the main components to consider is the desired sensing range, as this will influence the impeller size that is implemented into the system. The impeller size regulates the minimum and maximum flow rate that can be handled by the flow meter. Determining the system accuracy requirements will consequently influence the total number of magnets and Hall sensors needed to achieve said accuracy. The primary source of inaccuracies comes in the form of frictional losses in the mechanical assembly. These losses typically originate in the bearing, which influences the ability of the impeller to rotate proportionally to the flow rate. Additionally, the force of the liquid flowing through the meter must overcome the initial frictional force of the bearing in order to begin moving the impeller, thereby establishing the minimum flow rate that can be handled by the meter. Other mechanical errors can come in the form of magnet placement. Magnets should be equally spaced and mounted planar to the top of the impeller. Errors in placement can lead to errors in the speed calculations. Lastly, the long-term reliability of the magnetic flow meter stems from the contactless method of measuring fluid flow. The magnetic implementation has a longer device lifetime when compared to flow meters that operate on reed switches, which are susceptible to vibrations and have limited life due to the mechanical nature of the switches typically used in these systems. Unlike the switches, magnetic sensors are not susceptible to breakage during insulation and enable designers to create more compact designs. Magnetic sensing portfolio provides many options when designing for a magnetic flow meter. The DRV5011 is a small form factor Hall effect latch that boasts a bandwidth of 30 kHz. This device enables compact designs by providing a push-pull output that does not require an external pull-up resistor while operating from a low voltage 2.5 volt supply. The TMAG5110 and TMAG5111 provide two high bandwidth 40 kHz Hall effect latches in one package, available in various sensing directions in order to provide design flexibility to suit any mechanical constraints that may be present in your system. One latch can be used to measure the flow rate, while the second latch provides a directional information enabling reverse flow detection. The TMAG5123 offers in-plane sensing to enable flexibility in sensor and magnet placement, providing a high bandwidth 40 kHz output for high flow applications with an omnipolar configuration that allows the sensor to respond to either a south or north pole field, all while operating in a wide supply range from 2.5 volts to 38 volts. If we have an impeller that is properly designed to meet our flow requirements, there are a couple of design specifications that need to be taken into consideration, such as magnet placement and sensor placement. For this demo, we have decided to use axially split disc magnets. The magnets will rotate along with the impeller housing and are fitted in an alternating pattern based on the field's polarity. This results in similar behavior as if using a ring magnet with multiple poles. The frequency bandwidth is an important parameter for a Hall sensor because it determines the max rotational speed that we can detect from the impeller while it's still updating the output appropriately. The frequency bandwidth for a selected device should be at least 2, but ideally 3 times larger than the max electrical frequency of the impeller. If we were trying to optimize for resolution of the impeller's position, then we could increase the number of poles to obtain more transitions. But since a key care about is speed and not resolution, we can reduce the amount of poles in our system. As mentioned in the previous slide, with more poles, there are more transitions. The amount of pulses seen is determined by the amount of pole pairs present in our ring magnet. If we use 4 poles, 2 north and 2 south, then we'll see two output transitions throughout the impeller's 360-degree rotation. The sensor chosen is a DRV5011 Hall latch, and the next step is to identify the ideal distance from the magnet to the Hall sensor. If the sensor is too far from the magnet, there will not be enough magnetic flux for the output to latch. We can simulate what the magnetic field or B field would yield in a head-on approach to find an ideal placement range for the sensor. All we have to do is enter a couple of our chosen magnet parameters, followed by what our possible placement range would be. In this case, we can test the distance from 20 millimeters to 5 millimeters away from the sensor. We will be using a power supply voltage of 3.3 volts, and now we can select the device that we will be using, which will be the DRV5011 AD-DBZ, which is in a SOT23 package. Now we can click on Calculate B Field and B Out. If we look at the plot of the B field and focus on BZ component, we can tell that the N35 disc magnet, when placed directly above the Hall sensor, will produce a field above the BRP needed to latch the output anywhere from 5 millimeters to approximately 12 millimeters. In our design, we have placed the Hall sensor 6.5 millimeters away from the magnets. Here's our completed system. We have added the flow meter module to this flow setup. The flow setup allows the water to flow from the top tank into two parallel paths. Each path has a commercially available flow meter in series with our module in order to obtain a reference measurement for comparison. One path is set for low flow rates and the other is set for high flow rates. In order to confirm our system behaves as intended, we should be getting a linear output behavior as we increase the rate. Here we are able to verify that as we allow the water to flow, we can observe a switching frequency in our Hall sensor output. When we increase the flow, we can observe that our Hall sensor's frequency has risen. When several more data points are collected, we are able to verify a linear behavior and are able to create a correlation formula that converts the output frequency of the Hall sensor to a GPM or LPM flow measurement with a plus or minus 1% accuracy. This concludes our demonstration and video on designing flow meters with Hall effect sensors. If you'd like to learn more about this topic, please refer to these articles and videos. You can also download the STL files for the flow meter you have seen in this video. Please visit ti.com/halleffect for more resources and tools. Thanks for watching!